Cabot Bigham, and here's your Jamaican
Fraser
boy, McConnell.
McConnell. Yeah, McConnell with a great start on the inside line. Bigham had that car loaded up hard. The Audi, though, loses out. Gets out, dragged down to turn one. Bigham goes wide, going to cut back to the inside line. Oh, McConnell just shuts the door. Look how dusty the tarmac is there. McConnell rotates the car around now. Okay, this is where we've seen everybody who's lost the start. Everybody has gone joker. Cabot Bigham goes straight away.
So again, either first or third, Liam, that's what you're saying?
Yeah, to be honest, I'll give you my strategy now because it's over. I was going for joker for the lead.
Joker
because
for the lead.
It worked for me 10 years ago at X Games, and take the guy in with you for sure. I was going in the joker and Travis would have followed me for sure, but the plan didn't work out.
That would have been cool. I'm kind of gutted we haven't seen it now. That's just... Oh, Fraser just runs the front wheels across the top of the
at this
but
point
tidy.
Now on the track, though, see, earlier on in the event, we were clearing the jump, no problem. You now can't stop. You just simply can't stop at that corner. So you're better off casing the jump just to scrub the speed off so you can get around the corner. Because if you clear the land and grease it, you're going off the next one.
But you have the potentiality of breaking suspension.
Yeah, well... It's a balance. This track, honestly, at the moment, is one big compromise. Yeah.
5.9 was the gap. It's 6.1 now to Bigham. 6.0 at the last check. Let's see when Bigham comes over the line now. And then McConnell's got to either do what most people have done. 6.6.
Wow.
So McConnell's killing this. So he could easily stay out, Liam. He could afford to stay out.
Fraser's been fast all day, though. You know, Fraser's been fast all day. But I think it's the right strategy. Why go in? You know, you've got a faster lap time. Create some more dust, stay out in front, have a clear track the whole race. So that's the right strategy.
I don't think you'll have raced Fraser so far,
never.
Will you? But
no,
I guess
never
you
have.
Kind of.
He's been doing some great driving.
I was going to say, you went across ARX when he did Nordic as well. Yeah.
Seen a lot of him. He's had some great races. He's new boy to the. To let's say to
he's
the club,
a, he's, good lad,
he's doing a great job.
He's
absolutely.
A good lad.
He's the greenhorn, so you've already shamed him, right? You've already hazed him.
Look how tidy he was in here again. To be fair, Bigham was also tidy on his run. So again, look, get it slowed down, get it rotated.
You can hear the car almost stalling. Almost stalling. So there is just that little grip now. Everyone's on the same track, though, so everyone's got the same problem.
So Fraser McConnell now, he has to go for that joker lap. Look at that, 8.74. That was that last clip right there at the end. But Cabot Bigham, what do you got?
His rear window's open, so the rear quarter windows can be taken out so you can access the top of the rear dampers easily. And if you watch Francis' rear quarter window, it's open, so that car is going to be absolutely full of dust. And breathing it in, it can be really hard work.
9 second gap between McConnell and Bigham, and he's definitely going to take the lead, but now he's got to keep it clean. As Liam is just describing here, what's going on track, it gets loose as he go up in the silt, kind of pace, just keep it slow, keep it mellow. And Cabot Bigham, he hasn't had a ton of practice out here on the course. And this course is just completely modifying. We're talking about the different variables. Vehicles, of course, but it's just transforming throughout the day and the weekend.
The window's gone completely for Fraser.
I don't know if it's going to be helping him up. He's probably going to be drawing the dust back out.
That's true. He's going to take the win here, but it's not a win for his mechanics because they're going to get that Hoover out and they're going to be really busy in the back of that car for right until he's next practice.
You can actually see inside. It's full of dust.
Yeah, the inside of the screen looks. So it's a great win for McConnell, really confident one. Got in front of Bigham and then just extended that gap.
I didn't want to be sitting out your top eight, great eight, all that stuff. I'm looking forward to it, if I'm honest. But I think it's a great format. It's 100% a great format, and it's giving good action.
Talk us through what you're seeing from Fraser here.
Well, Fraser's had good times all day. You know, he was fast this morning when the track was tacky. He's been fast even when it's greased up now, and it's super, super slippery, but he's adapted to it really well. I'm jealous, if I'm honest, because I definitely have not done that. So fair play to him for adapting. He's got good times, I think. He will go quite far through his battles now.
All right. Well, as Fraser McConnell advances on.